G'day all. Sunday morning, driving into Geelong. Don't know what I'm going to show you. Guess I'll just drive into town and show you where I grew up. What's my hometown and always will be. Just getting off the highway now. Even though I love gambling, but not that. I don't think any animal should be used for any of that shit. Full set of lights, great. Well, over there on the left, the oil refinery. Well, Shell, until 4 years ago, I think. It was built in the 50s, Shell got rid of it. Great. Gonna get stuck in all of his lights now. Melbourne Road. Melbourne's back the other way where I came from, but it's also part of the Princess Freeway, which is Highway 1 in this country. On for you, Max. Dan Murphy's bottle shop. All the liquor you want. About a minute, there's something that's painful to me. Very painful. suburb here, Moore Lane and North Shore, very working class. Very, very working class. Here's why. On the left there, maybe you can see the sign now, the old Ford plant. It was in my hometown for 41 years and closed in 2016. I spent 3 weeks short of 22 years in there. Dad did 34, I think. My older brother did, I think he was 36, he was there right to the end. Pity, it's one of those towns, you either knew someone that worked there or you did work there. The old Ford plant, but that's still used now, but it's a carpet factory now, just on the left. Fucking roadworks. About in town in about 3 minutes' time if I don't get any more red lights. Oh, the trees on either side of the road here, they're also named after Vietnam vets who had fallen. There's a Vietnam vet memorial over on the left there also. Alright, Mercer Street. This will take us right into town. Fucking lights. The Yarra Street goes straight down to the bay. Subject tonight is Bruce Springsteen. As it. Thank you. Tyrone Street. This one's a bit picturesque. It has my favourite pub. One of only two in the town centre that I haven't been thrown out of. Just up on the left, it's called Lammy's. The building on the left here, it's part of an old wool store. And the ones on the right, I guess that name Lammy's is there for a reason. Sheep, wool, and no, I don't fuck sheep either. But no, this pub's been there since, Christ, since I started going out when I was, you know, 18. Dead ahead, the library, and what was the old cop shop and courthouse to the left of it. Christ, it's windy.
This song is called I've Seen the Rain, and it was written by my daddy, Mr. Jim Moore. He wrote it back in Vietnam about 40 years ago, and I grew up singing it with him at different Vietnam vet functions. It's how I learned how to harmonize and how to love an acoustic guitar. And the way that we recorded it, that was my dad's first time in a recording studio, and he always said singers don't really have to work too hard, and he changed his mind that day. We did it live, him and I in the vocal booth together, him playing and singing and me harmonizing. One take, straight through. It was really, really a good time. It was really special to be able to record a song with my dad. The first song I ever learned. We hope you like it. We're dedicated to all the vets out there.
What do we got here? Post office on the right. The clock tower on it. Ryrie Street. Same thing, shops, restaurants. Pretty touristy. This town. Geelong. Its population. It's about 240,000. That's if you count all the little outlying towns and hamlets. Like where I've got my place. About 20 minutes from here, down on the Ballarine Peninsula. Can't wait to move down here one day when I retire. Another one of my favourite pubs, the Sporting Globe. It used to be known as the Preston Hotel. That one was great. Downstairs every Saturday night, they'd have the acoustic duo bands, stuff like that. And a bar, and upstairs they had like the nightclub where chicks could go and dance and act stupid or whatever. Christ, I'm tired and sleeping off. Take you down to Eastern Beach.
beach.
We have seen the rain together. We survived the pain forever. Oh, it's good to be home again.
I think one of the good things about this place is they've kept a lot of the old stuff and some of it's modern. When I was growing up, the town used to be known as Sleepy Hollow, and it was. It was just boring, and the wrong councils were in power, and they let the place go. They tried to keep it too traditional, and the place was just a dive. You just wanted to get out. You just did not want to be around. It was boring. That name Sleepy Hollow, that was no joke. It was just boring. But when the right people got in the power, they fixed everything up. I mean, even these apartments over here on the left, that's all relatively new. Before, it was just decrepit and decaying. Cryo Bay dead ahead. And Eastern Beach. Hairy touristy. I'll tell you something now. 95% of the cars along here and the people you see will be tourists. Most up from Melbourne just for the day trip. Yacht Club on the left. Someone might be hearing this. It might be familiar to them. Maybe the kids on it. That's been going ever since I was a little kid also. One of those things that will just never die. Speed humps on it. It's called Ritchie Boulevard. Saturday nights used to be a bit of a drag strip, but they put the speed humps in to stop that. One of the things that was fun and taken away. On the right there, there's two restaurants in that building. La Parisienne, that's the classy one. And right down the end, the Warship Cafe. These are had some great top-notch fast food there. You wouldn't actually call it fast food. You'd call it, I don't know, classy fast food, I guess you'd call it. When you're paying $25 for a hamburger, you know why in the end. This all, same thing like I said before, this was all decaying at one stage. Now it's picturesque, more men of them. Well, the Sheraton, oh, Novotel Hotel, sorry, it was Sheraton at one stage. This is actually where the first original Ford plant was. Ford of Canada set it up. The parts used to come from Canada off the pier there. They get assembled here. That went on for a few years until the plant down on Melbourne Road was built. For Loose Goose, if you ever see this, you'll know what it is. Your Seamus Departments, which got sold. It's just there on the left. In fact, I don't even think it's a department thing anymore. Big town, small city. Which is exactly what I like. It's never too busy, except for Christmas and New Year and the summer periods. Might just go across the top of MacKillop Street. building on the right. That became a disco. The one disco I got thrown out of for life, and that was intentional, just so we didn't have to go back in there ever. Bridges Hotel. It used to be a Travelodge, used to be Peculiar, used to be everything. Second favourite pizza restaurant. It's around the left here. Top of the town on the left. This one's Mirrible Street looking down towards Cryo Bay. National Hotel. Right there. Used to be good for alternative bands and punk bands at one stage. Back of the cinemas. St. Mary's Cathedral on the right, where had everything. Christening, communion, confirmation, wedding, all held there. There's also one other thing about that building. There's a council law that says no building shall be built taller than that, ever, in the town. That's cool, Empire Grill. I haven't been there for years. Anyway, that's just a bit of Geelong. Off to Seymour now. Oh, I don't know. An upload this one day. Thank you.
when we don't know what to do. I know him. You call to my name, but I love you anyway.
Was it 15 years ago? Those palm trees, they weren't there. Now it looks great. Anyway, that's just a bit of Geelong, which is me, really. Hope you got something out of that. Not a great deal. Not much of a talker when there's only one person in the car. I find it hard if there was someone sitting next to me. You wouldn't shut me up. Actually, you would. You'd probably punch me in the mouth. I'll try and make another one later and do a better job of it.